By now, I'm probably the 1,000th person to tell you about RuneScape ever since old school servers got put up. But basically, old school RuneScape is back. Alright. I used to play a lot of RuneScape back in the day, boys. I used to do homework or literally anything while playing RuneScape when I was younger. I don't know quite how to describe the feeling of playing RuneScape other than that it's the chore I want to fulfill. Essentially, what keeps you ticking in RuneScape are all these fucking numbers called skills. Basically, there's a billion of them and you want them all to be level 99. Why? I don't really know. So you can do some quest or something. But RuneScape feels like it's so much more than that. And I don't quite mean just because of the nostalgia. There's something genuine about RuneScape to me, something pure, in a sense. But I'll talk about that in a hot minute here. So if you're unaware, the old school RuneScape, or RS2 if you will, has been around since I believe 2013. They released a backed up build of the game from late 2007, and they've also recently released a version of it on mobile devices. This is when I first heard of it. My older brother broke into my house one day, thrilled, and told me all about it. Of course, I immediately had to try it out. Unfortunately, you can't roll back your RS3 account into old school, but really it's a blessing in disguise. Kind of. For which I will explain. Starting up old school RuneScape again and beginning fresh means you have nothing. Obviously. You simply run a quick tutorial which arms you with a few essential items, and you're off into the great beyond in mere minutes. That's it. There you are, a fresh soul with no instructions, sitting dumbfounded in Lumbridge with the world at your feet. Nobody's really telling you where to go or what to do. You can just wander off in a direction without a care in the world. This is always something I very much appreciated about RuneScape. Less is an MMO and more of just a game. From the instant the game starts, you can almost go anywhere, talk to anybody, explore corners, and, like, cut down trees and stuff. It's fucking awesome! I could go on for a while about how when I started playing RuneScape, things like the Grand Exchange didn't exist, and that if it came up to the player to keep his wits about him when trading or talking with other players, but I won't really. I'm more of just going to focus on the 2007 experience itself. So you wander around, and well, maybe you talk to a guide or two or something, and before long, you're probably off leveling up a skill. RuneScape has a lot of them, and they all serve a purpose. To what end? Well, that's for you to decide. For me, I want to go through and complete all of the amazing quests I can get my man hands on. When I was but a boy, I couldn't appreciate some of the finer writing in RuneScape's quests, but many of them are really top-notch. Quests in RuneScape are the real meat of the game. In RuneScape, there's no story or main questline to follow. There's just simply people and the way you interact with them. Or, I suppose, the way the game makes you interact with them in most cases, as they are all quite linear. There are a lot of quest chains and quests that are directly tied to others, but they're all crafted to be handled at any point when the player is ready. There's quests that range from simple and zany like Ernest the Chicken, in which you explore a spooky, haunted mansion to help a mad scientist change back a man whom he'd transformed into a chicken, to very huge, mature, and serious questlines like the Regicide Elf questlines, in which you overthrow a king hellbent on seizing demonic powers to destroy the world, or something like that. I can't really think of a single bad quest. Okay, I can think of quests I'd probably choose not to play again, but each quest in RuneScape is something you should just sit back and enjoy as it happens. Coming from experience, I know it's easy to get impatient with them, but once you finish it, you feel satisfied because of the role you played in every quest and the story you got to be a part of. I think the quests in particular is what made RuneScape age so well. None of these quests really progress a much higher purpose. As I said earlier, there really isn't a quote-unquote main storyline to RuneScape. You just walk around and, hey, you got anything to do around here? Let's describe a few of my favorite quests real quick, shall we? Okay, go! Murder Mystery. So the basis of this quest is all about investigation. You have suspects to interrogate, clues to find, and of course, there's a splash of humor in the dialogue as well. The cool thing about this quest is that the outcome is randomized, so it's a little different every time you play through it. This also means it's up to the player to figure out the mystery. It's a lot shorter if you know what to do, though. Underground Pass. Underground Pass is this crazy quest, a part of that regicide quest chain I mentioned earlier. After exposing the King of West Ardon's... Well, that's how I pronounce it anyway. So after you expose the King of Ardon's facade, he flees through the pass to the Elfland, and the player has to navigate through it to establish a contact with the elves. But I can't get enough of this quest. It's a serious quest, but it's so bizarre. Bizarre in a very Alice in Wonderland sort of way, very rabbit hole-like. In which the deeper you go, the stranger things seem to become. Things start relatively normal, some pitfalls, some traps, but soon things start to get weird as you eventually have to go down this well. Then there's like a unicorn in a cage and you have to roll a boulder over it to kill the unicorn and...
And you could have it all.
There are these paladin guys who are trying to investigate things too, and you have to kill them for these badges they carry, because I guess borrowing them was just out of the question. It gets weirder from there. All the while, your chat box gets filled with these temptations of power from the pass's presumed lord, Iben, the self-proclaimed son of Zamorak. There's a great sense of isolation, and things become weirder and weirder. It may remind some players of games like Penumbra or Amnesia, The Dark Descent. Definitely not for the faint of heart, ladies and gentlemen. This quest is the middle portion of the Dorgeshun quest line, and the entire chain is fantastic. This is one of the more serious quest lines about a lost tribe of cave goblins making contact with the surface world. It deals a lot more with the political tensions between humans and monsters, with groups in the quest such as humans against monsters, or simply ham. Ha, funny. You befriend the goblin Zanik. Let's go with that. As she becomes the ambassador of the goblin people. Together, you two work to foil the plans of Ham, which includes stealth segments where Zanik uses a crossbow to fucking cap people. I'm not gonna sit here and preach about it, the nuances of the writing. It's really good, and broaches the topics of racism and gray morality very gracefully. It's not heavy-handed or over-the-top, and the focus is always on the quests at hand and the two characters of Zanik and yourself. There's a few twists and turns, and I love the world-building in it. So as a matter of fact, much of RuneScape's approach is very dry humor. A cool thing in the game is the option to, quote-unquote, examine objects, props, and monsters. Usually the game will tell you fuck all about it, like, raccoon. Wow, that was informative. But more often than not, you'll just get a little witty response about something. Rack. Makes you taller. I don't know, brightens my day between transits because I don't use magic and I have to walk everywhere! I believe Jagex is a British game developer, so a lot of humor is very cut and dry. Imagine Monty Python, for those of you unfamiliar with the usual brand of the English variety. Say what you want about the old school graphics, but I kinda dig them. Some of the textures aren't actually too terrible, but to me RuneScape is more about the choice of color palettes. Just by looking at the map, you can tell exactly what an area will be like before you even get there. I think this is pretty important, and you can tell me it's obvious, but RuneScape does a really good job of choosing colors and communicating areas to you. It's very easy to remember Varrok apart from Falador by their general use of colors. Although I remember a time when Falador was gray. Am I cool yet for that? I also can't praise the soundtrack enough either. Okay, I'm sucking off RuneScape pretty hard right now. Just give me a few more minutes to gush. There's plenty of bad things about the game, but for right now, soundtrack. RuneScape has a lot of music. A lot of music. One of my favorite parts of the game was always entering a new area and receiving a little red band of text saying I unlocked a new piece of music. Old school RuneScape currently has 581 tracks of music to listen to, and each one is played in glorious MIDI. Oh yeah, MIDI. Oh yeah. There's a certain charm to MIDI instruments that can't be emulated anywhere else. It's a bit ironic that the MIDI instrument attempts at sounding real creates a quality of genuineness that can't be captured by anything else. That being said, RS's soundtrack is very inspired. Playing the game without this music feels as if part of its soul is missing. So much atmosphere is generated from these old tracks. Tracks such as Scapesoft or Miles Away definitely create a vibe of a wondrous world filled with emotions. However, tracks such as Forever, which play in Edgeville, are the scores that truly ground the player into the world. Edgeville, a town which borders the horrifying wilderness to the north, is full of a somber mood and even a bit of ancient history. This piece of music called Forever perfectly encapsulates this vibe. When you enter Edgeville and this music plays, you feel completely moved into a different world. Looking at the world map shows you only to be a quick jaunt away from Varrok or even the barbarian village to the south. But when you're here, with this music, you become entirely isolated from everything else. Suddenly you feel you're at the true edge of the common world, as the stories of the No Man's Wilderness are right before your very feet. The same could be said about many places in the world. At first glance, RuneScape may look like a big map, and sure, it's a good size, and there's plenty of places to go. But the closer you examine, the more you see how truly condensed everything is. And this isn't really a bad thing. I don't need vast plots of nothingness in between trying to find things to do, that's not what I'm trying to say at all. But just look here. The land of Mortania is just a quick walk from East Varrok, really only separated by this river. There's a whole questline about how the river is blessed or something like that. But this land of dreadful, Romanian-style monsters and evil is actually just a several-minute walk outside the Varrok city. But I bet you really never thought of it that way, did you? The game is right to make you go through a quest to enter this area, but I think it's also the music of the area that really helps sell the idea that suddenly you're in a whole new place, with new threats and adventures. If places like Mortania only had about one or two pieces of music, or even recycled music from anywhere else in the game, it simply wouldn't work as well, in my opinion. RS3 even orchestrated many of the RS2 tracks for use in the current game. And what do you know? They're pretty good. It might even be a bit nostalgia blind for me to say, but I just like the classic MIDI more, you know? I respect the fuck out of Jagex for honoring their game's music in such a way. A lot of games get live soundtracks these days, but it's clear that Jagex truly feels the soul in the music. For the most part, I highly enjoy RS3's remasters, as I've said before, but I have to note that a lot of tracks are far from perfect. A solid amount of tracks aren't bar-for-bar remasters of the original work, which I see some people have issues with. I frankly don't have any problems with the concept of adding new bars of music or even just changing the tone of an old track. I think it's the spirit of RuneScape to evolve and change and generally make something that's worth missing. But some of these tracks definitely suffer from production quality fumbling. For example, the Castle Wars track sounds just awful. I don't own the CD or any sold version of the soundtrack, so perhaps the CD version is mastered better, but this version in particular sounds very distant. The melody on the organ is completely drowned out by the brass, and the marimba that chimes in is clearly not in focus. The marimba is not as much a foul, but it's definitely distracting. You have other tracks, such as Doorways, which I thought previously captured a window in RuneScape. This piece of music sounds very melancholy to me, but it has a certain energy to it. It feels like I'm close to the edge of the world, kind of like Edgeville's Forever, but its flavor is entirely unique. Sometimes I swear I could feel the temperature in the air just by listening to the piece of music. The bar by the outskirts of Varrock always gave me a welcome and very soothed feeling. Even when I had no purpose for being there, everything about it felt so quaint, and I wanted more every time. Just the fact that an area like this had its own piece of music gave me the purpose to explore it, like I felt someone really wanted me to. This version in RS3 is... well, it's not very good. It completely destroys the subtlety of traveling in the area. It no longer feels like there's a warm summer storm coming over the hills, which I always kind of felt from hearing this. For some reason, it's gotta be grandiose and epic. Okay, fine. Be that way. I did say that I don't mind reimagining the old score, but I don't even think this piece of music is tolerable on a technical scale. Everything feels like it's in absolute discord. The melodies are drowned out again. The percussion feels incredibly out of place, and the harmonies are damn near non-existent. Nothing can seem to be focused long enough for the score to grasp any concept, at least to me anyway. This piece of music is just all over the place and a complete mess. Alternatively, I'd like to compare a little bit of another studio-recorded and reorchestrated soundtrack called Distant Worlds, which is from Final Fantasy Music. As you can tell, for the most part compared to the previous RuneScape music, this music offers a far better mixed experience, and it's far easier to hear everything about the music. Every nuance is properly highlighted appropriately. But let's look on the flip side, shall we? There's some really good tracks too. Not only is there actually new tracks of music in RS3, but there's some fantastic reorchestrations as well. Since we covered a lot of Varrock-esque areas, how about we try another place? Some of my favorite bits of music were from Ardone. Well, does anyone actually know how to pronounce that? Is that how you pronounce that? Okay, whatever. Baroque is a fantastic rework, I think. It lacks the harpsichord that I think the name came from, but everything about it is really well made. The thing that I think gives MIDI so much of its character is that it relies on strong melody to make up for its lack of dynamics, slurred notes, or generally unpleasing sounds. Baroque certainly respects that, and I think it turned out well as a result. So check this out. Back when RuneScape released their in-game playlist option, which allowed players to compile their favorite tracks together, these are what I had. this is the list that I made probably back in like 2010 or something. Really? I don't remember all these tracks. I remember most of them though. Not gonna lie, young me had some fucking good taste. I just really like RS's music, and I have a huge amount of respect for how much care and variety was put into their creation, and that Jagex allowed composers like Ian Taylor to put this much music into their game, when at a time, a lot of games usually had about 30 to 60 minute soundtracks. So finally, the moment I'm sure plenty of people have waited for. The god-awful things in this game. Let's get this out of the way. RuneScape is a giant grind fest. Oof, the grind is real. I think one of the mass appeals of RuneScape is that this big world offers you so much to do. Offers you so much busy work to do. You know, like fucking chores. Woodcutting, fishing, mining, smithing, fletching, fire making. The way RuneScape's EXP is laid out, it's usually pretty easy to start leveling up any stat. Usually around level 30 is when you start to feel the XP rush wear off and the XP per level starts to build up. Some skills are easier than others. Crafting, for example. At level 23, you can craft tiaras from one silver bar. This yields about 53 XP or so. On the other hand, you have smithing, which becomes harder and harder. But big deal, right? So the game's a little grindy. Really, that's fine. The big issue is that a lot of the old-school RuneScape team has acknowledged how grindy the game is, and has tried to make improvements on it. The only problem with that is that whenever a change comes along, it has to be run through a community poll, because the old-school team of Jagex is a whipped bitch. Doesn't do anything unless 75% of the community says it's alright. On one hand, I do think it's pretty great that Jagex acknowledges the community in such a way, but on the other hand, the people playing this game aren't game devs. Alright, Jagex is the game dev here. Lots of alternative means to skilling is rejected by the community. They have to pull to ask questions that are so simple about just making the game playable. Questions like, should all items you enchant be enchanted in a row automatically after casting the spell? Like, of course, why would I want to do it one at a fucking time? Due to such high polling standards, we don't get a lot of new things that would help the game or make the game more interesting. You know, things like new skills that would liven the experience, they don't exist. There are a lot of mini-games that help with the grinding process, but overall it's still a grind, but whatever. It's really mostly the community's fault, I think, that old-school RuneScape is such a horrible grind fest with no supplementary mediations to help it out. This does bring me to the conclusion that the old-school community, while generally full of adults, is full of people we like to call man-children. You know, elitists who have maxed out skills and then bitch that we can't have new ways to max skills because I already maxed my skill, so everyone else should have to do it that way too. Yeah, that kind of thinking is what ruins the game. All notions aside, it seems like the old school team works very hard to make RuneScape an accessible, fun experience for anyone who comes by. It gets very frequent updates. In fact, right before I finished editing this section, they released a new free quest that's really easy, but it's just the thought that counts to me, really. So my verdict on RuneScape? I like it still. Replaying an older version of it still feels like it used to, for better or for worse. But I respect Jagex for having things like the voting polls, where players can vote on adding in new features or fixing problems in the game. They've even added places that are exclusive to old school. That's incredible! The thing is I don't really know who to recommend RuneScape to besides people who have a connection to it already. If you like MMOs, I guess you could look into it, but really, it's a very isolated experience. In any case, those are a lot of my thoughts about RuneScape. If you haven't played RuneScape or you haven't replayed RuneScape, I hope this may have sparked some interest in you, and if not, that's fine too. You know, RuneScape's kinda hard to get into. Alright, see you later!